So Mira here is wondering sometimes, particularly in Todoist, but this could be true for other systems too. Should we put something into a project, or should we categorize it under another task as a subtask, right? Do you actually have an example that comes to
Yes.
mind? Yeah, okay.
So for me, because it's with, I have my university studies as
Yes.
the project, and then I have individual papers as tasks,
Right.
but then like they're broken down. I need to submit, for example, I've got a essay due next Friday, and I want to get the readings done first, then I do the notes, then I do the drafts, then I do the, and to put it as a project seems like a big
That
thing.
does. That seems like kind of like a, it's almost unnecessarily like,
Big, yeah. But
yeah,
then
I
I don't want
totally
to
agree with
lose
you.
due dates. Like the due date for the actual completion is not till Friday, but then there are subtitle, like little things that I need to get done that are due each day. So I just noticed I was struggling to
Totally.
get that in and make sure I had what I needed to do today,
Okay,
but I have an
so
eye on the.
that's interesting that you actually have, I agree with you, there are due dates for finishing a paper, especially if it's a big paper, like you said. In that, so yes, in Todoist, for example, you could create subtasks under one task with different deadlines. I tried it out and I never liked it. It somehow, it was always confusing to me. So if I were in your shoes, I would actually create a project per paper and just have, just then it's very simple. I just have to do, I just have tasks within a project with different due dates. And thankfully it's not hard to create a project in Todoist. You click on the plus sign and you type in something and now it's a project and now you can put once a project is done, once a paper is done and submitted, you can archive the project easily as well. So yeah, I feel like, so that's one option. The other option is simply to create a single task and then use comments. That's what I do a lot. Either use comments or use the description field. So let me show you what I mean. So in Todoist, let's say I was saying a paper about topic XYZ, right? So that's a big task. And then the due date would be by 10, 8, read the literature about it, by 10, 15, make first draft. So I would literally just do it like this,
And would
and I would put this, the first due date would be, I actually, it should be, the due date should be like, I would make it more granular. So it's like by 10, 5, read the first article, 10, 6, read the second article. I would make it more granular, read third article or whatever. 10, 8, finish all articles, like that. And so that way I would schedule it as 10, 5, 10, 5.
you'd reschedule it each day.
I would reschedule each day, and each day I would come in here and go, yep, I did that. I read the first article, and I would just delete it.
Yeah.
Or I would, if you somehow want to keep it so that you can copy and paste in the future as a template, you could basically have a little, I would make a little, star and say done, and I would literally just go like this. Okay, I did that, and I would just paste it down there. You see what I mean? So this is
Yep.
all in the description field. Todoist now has something called a description field. Let me see if I can find that thing now. See? Oh wait, let me sort by priority, sort by due date here. So paper about topic XYZ. There we go. So the description field, you can actually see a quick summary of everything in the description field. If it was in the comments, you couldn't see the summary. You can only see how many comments there are. You see
Yeah.
that? That's the difference between the description field and the comments field.
Yeah.
Yeah. So hope that helps.
Yep, thank you.
Thanks.